Hello everyone. Welcome to this video tutorial on creating a master detail report with a sub-report. This type of report has two reports, a master report and detail report. The master report is the primary report, providing an overview of data, and the detail report serves as the sub-report, providing detailed information about the data in the master report. In this video, I will show you how to create a master detail report where department name and group name are displayed in the master report, while employee ID, title, contact ID, vacation and sick leave are displayed in the detail report. First, I'll create a new report in the report server and name it Employee Details Subreport. This will serve as the detail report. Next, I need to retrieve the necessary data from the database to present it in the master detail report. I create a data source and a data set using my AdventureWorks database in Microsoft SQL Server. I have the database details in the form of a connection string. So I go to the advanced options to use my connection string. Then, I set the authentication type as none since the connection string already has the database credentials. This connects to the data source and opens the query designer. I enter the dataset name as employee details dataset. Because I already have the query to join tables for my dataset, I enable code mode to enter the SQL query. This query has two parameters, department name and department group name, which are prefixed with the @ symbol. Data is fetched by the SQL query based on these parameters. Then, I click the Finish button to save the dataset. Looking here, the dataset is created. Once the dataset is created, the department name and department group name parameters are automatically created in the parameter panel. Since the parameter values can be passed from the main report, I need to hide the parameters so that the parameter section will not be shown when previewing the report. To do that, I open the department name parameter and set its visibility option to hidden. I do the same for the department group name parameter as well. Next, I add a table to the report layout where I will display the employee details. I add the necessary columns and values to the table. Then, I format the table by changing the background color, font color, size, weight, and alignment. I have finished creating the detail report. The next step is to publish it so that it can be included in the main report through the subreport report item. I click the Publish button and the Publish as Report dialog opens. I choose the report category and save the changes. Looking here, subreport has been published. Next, I create a master report and name it Master Detail Report with subreport. Then I create the data source and data set following the same steps I used for the details report. Here, I enter the data set name Employee Summary Data Set and enter the SQL query. Then, I click Finish to save the data set. Before adding a table, let me add a header to this report to provide basic information about the report. First, I enable the header area, add a rectangle, and resize it. Then, I changed the background color to enhance the look and feel. To add the header text, I add a text box inside the rectangle and enter employee details since the table displays employee details. Next, I format the text to enhance the look and feel and change the vertical alignment. The header is done. Next, I will add a master table to display an overview of employee data, specifically the department and group names. I add a table to the report. Remove the unnecessary columns and rows from the table and resize it. I assign the dataset value so that the fields from the dataset are used in the table. Next, I add grouping to the table. I select the table cell and click Details in the Row Group section. Next, I open the grouping dialog by clicking Set Groups in the Properties panel. Select the name field for the group by value, so that values will be grouped based on a selected field, and save the changes. Next, I assign the name field to the table cell, and then I insert a new row by selecting the inside group, below option. In the added row, assign the group name field to the table cell. In the same way, add another row. Right-click a cell in the new row and insert the subreport item inside it. We will use this to configure the detail report within the master report. Next, I click Report Path in the Properties panel and select the subreport path to configure the report. Now the subreport is included in the main report. The main report needs to pass data to the subreport through a parameter. So, I click the Set Parameter button in Properties and assign the parameter name and its value. Next, I format the table by changing the font size, style, border, and alignment. I am done creating the main report. Now that the master detail report is ready, I switch to preview mode. Here, we can see the employee summary details displayed in the master report, and each employee's details are displayed in the detail report. In this video, I have shown you how to create a master detail report with a subreport item in bold reports. In the description below, I have provided a link to a blog explaining the procedure used in this video, for your reference. If you found this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.